snow fences in there to directly concentrate snow. They create a snow drift and reduce the amount of snow that's available to blow across the road, and they're used worldwide. Well-planned snow fences can be used to augment the water available for ponds and reservoirs, too. Snow fences are designed to deposit snow, and there are ports. Wind and snow slip through them, but the wind and snow are slow enough that the snow falls out in very predictable patterns. Changing the design of a snow fence, making it solid, for instance, changes the physics of the wind and snow movement and deposition. A properly designed solid snow fence will leave a zone behind it which remains clear. Stockmen often take advantage of this phenomenon on the windy plains of Wyoming with windbreaks. Their design directs wind and snow away from an area that we want to remain clear. If you are sometimes challenged with a pile of wind-driven snow, know that you too can manage your snow problem using this good Wyoming research. From the University of Wyoming Cooperative Extension
Service, causes accidents and makes clearing the roads difficult, sometimes impossible. Snowdrifts can reduce sight and cause loss of vehicle control. To keep this from happening, a snow fence is used to minimize the amount of snow drifting on the roadways. There are several types of snow fences, including wood, plastic, and living fences. A living fence is made by planting trees, shrubs, and/or native grasses. These plantings create a vegetative barrier to trap and control blowing and drifting snow. Snow fences have been an excellent solution for preventing drift formation over the 20 years they've been in place in Wyoming. The remarkable effectiveness of properly designed snow fences saves money and makes the road much safer.